Hello everyone, today's tutorial is going to be about the solar system project on Scratch. Okay, on Scratch. It's been a long time since I did any Scratch videos, so let's just show you what I mean. So yeah, this is basically what I am currently doing right now. I know, I mean, it's not to scale and everything, but I guess this is some sort of way to represent the solar system. So yeah, here it is. It shows this is the asteroid belt, and if I hover over it, it will show the sun. This star is the closest star to our home planet. Distance is 1 AU, which is the distance between the Earth and the Sun. Jupiter is the first and biggest planet made from gas. There's a storm which is 3 times bigger than Earth, and yeah, that's what we're gonna make. So first we just make a new project, and now what you wanna do is you just wanna get a backdrop called stars. Wait, what? Stars. And now we wanna upload a sprite called yeah, sun, and we reduce it to size, depends on what we want it to be. Let's just make a 10, and let's make this 0, and y is negative 15. Let's just do it like that. Now, what we want to do is we want to make sure that when the green flag is clicked, you want to just make sure that this just turns. Let's just make it turn. Turn like maybe 1 degree every 0.2 seconds. I don't know. I'm just gonna say turn 1 degree every 0.05 degrees. There you go. Should it moves just like that. That should be good. Now we upload Mercury. Okay, now we just put this to x35 and y22 and reduce the size of 5. -22, and then we make this planet orbit. So forever when the green flag is clicked, move 2 steps and turn left. Oh wait, not 15 degrees. Move 3 steps, move turn 2 degrees. And we'll make sure it goes to the correct spot. Okay, this has to point. I forgot to say that we have to make sure that this points in 6 degrees. There we go. I need to make this turn 3 degrees. There we go. This is now orbiting the sun. And now what we do is we want to show forever in the green flag script. Boys all, no needs forever, and pen down. Now we'll just switch to by default blue. So now this is our, now this is Mercury. Now we just wanna repeat the same process with pretty much all of the planets. So now, once you have done doing the orbiting, now you can just do the other stuff. Well, before I'm gonna show you the other things you need to do, I'm just gonna say the X position and how many degrees they should turn, because, you know, it took me a long time to figure that out for all of them. So I don't want you to struggle, so I'm gonna tell them. So for Venus, go to X 53, negative 22, pointing direction 6, move 2 steps, and turn 2 degrees. They're always gonna move 2 steps. And yeah. For Earth, go to X 70, Y 22, and turn 1.5 degrees. Then, here, Mars, go to X 88, Y negative 22, so it's going to be negative 22, and then turn 1.25 degrees. Then, on Jupiter, go to X 124, and turn 9 degrees to the left. Still move 2 steps, and still Y is negative 22. Saturn, go to X 142 and turn 0.8 degrees. For Uranus, we have X to 160 degrees and turn 0.725 degrees. And for Neptune, we are going to go to X 178 and turn left to 0.65 degrees. So, and also we just wanna do when green flags clicked, raise all and pin down. So yeah, that's pretty much done with the orbit. So yeah, now the last thing we're gonna do before the next section of my video is to show the Earth year. So if you didn't notice, well, hopefully you did. When I did, you see Earth year. And then every time it finishes its orbit, the Earth year is gonna change by one. So, let's do the same here. So, we go to variables, make a variable, and call it, call it year or Earth year, whatever you want. So in the beginning, set year to 0. Now, when the green flags quit, if direction equals 6, because originally it started on 6 degrees. So if direction equals 6, then it will then the year number will change by 1. So go to variables and change year by 1. So now when you try this, we should see that by the time Earth will reach its point right here, changes. There we go. So now we got the first section done. I'll see you in the next section when I'm gonna talk about how I do these quotes, like, and these, like, information, speech bubbles. So yeah, hope you like this tutorial, and I'll see you in the second section. Bye.